Deputy Boyd Barrett. Deputy Boyd Barrett.
Thanks, Count Corla. Tánaiste, we don't need a rainy day fund, we need a sunny day fund, because the current heat wave and the Irish water warnings of water shortages have yet again exposed the completely decrepit state of Ireland's water infrastructure and the disastrous consequences of decades of underinvestment by Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil led governments. And in particular, the current crisis has been exacerbated by the decisions from 2010 onwards by Fianna Fáil and the Green Party first, continued by Fine Gael and Labour, to cut by €50 million a year the capital investment programme in fixing the water infrastructure. To the point that we now have 49% of water leaking out of the mains infrastructure, not from household wastage. And it's particularly infuriating that spokespeople for the parties that actually imposed the cuts and austerity on the water investment programme then have the cheek to blame householders for the problem when they know that the expert commission that they set up to look into water usage in this country concluded categorically, that there was no evidence of excessive household wastage in this country. That, in fact, household usage in Ireland is lower than in Britain, where they have water charges. Lower, I repeat. That's what your expert commission concluded. We use 110 litres per day per house, whereas in Britain they use 140 litres, where they have water charges. So why do government spokespeople and representatives of parties that actually slashed the investment programme into water infrastructure persist in blaming householders? The reality is householders are reaping the bitter fruits of your decisions to cut investment in fixing our decrepit, broken water infrastructure. And the evidence, Tánaiste, is still there. There's a leak on Kildare Street that's been there for 2 weeks. Go out and look at it. 2 weeks, water leaking out in Kildare Street. On Friday, I managed to get on national radio the case of one street in Dunleary where they reported water leakage and water shortages in January. The Irish Water did not arrive to look at that problem until June and say they can't fix it till August. That is the consequence. That leakage, 700 million litres a day, wasted because you have failed to invest in fixing our broken water infrastructure. Why don't you just admit that?
Thank you, Deputy Tánaiste.
Deputy, sometimes it's hard to know where to start with you in terms of this issue. What I would say is, thank God we do have a single water entity now that is trying to manage the challenges that we face nationally. It is actually doing a reasonably good job. The reason why we have so many leaks in our pipes is because we had over 30 different entities managing water infrastructure in the past. Many of those under-resourced in terms of what they needed to do. What we now have is a single entity which is planning for the national needs of water usage in the future, and they are managing a difficult weather situation right now and will continue to over the summer months. They have, for the first time, a coherent plan to reduce leakage significantly from 45% leaks to 38% leaks by 2021. They have a capital investment programme which is secure, thanks to the agreement politically in this House. And so for the first time we have a proper, coherent, organised, funded plan to actually fix Ireland's water infrastructure once and for all. We have a plan to actually deal with shortages in Dublin, which wouldn't have been solved by local authorities in Dublin on their own because this is going to require a national approach to bring water from the Shannon to the eastern parts of this country and to Dublin in particular, but also many surrounding counties of Dublin as well. But the approach that you would advocate for would be to localise everything in terms of decision-making, planning, expenditure and so on. And we know the results of that policy. Leaks all over the country and the inability for coordination between counties and nationally. And so what I would say is I would like to thank Irish Water for the work that they are doing in very difficult circumstances right now, the partnerships that they're developing with organisations like the IFA and others, and the partnerships that they have with local authorities to be able to concentrate on the areas that are feeling the most water stress and shortage right now, to ensure that the resources and experience and skill set in Irish Water that comes from economies of scale can actually give the response that's necessary as quickly as possible. Secondly, can I say, nobody is blaming householders. What we are saying in government is we are asking the country to respond in a way that they did during other extreme weather circumstances earlier in the year, when communities came together, they supported each other, and they should be doing that now as well, to ensure that neighbours take other neighbours into account in terms of how they use water over the coming weeks, due to a lack of rainfall and obvious shortages that will come from that. And that appeal coming from government is something that I hope communities and individual householders and businesses will heed.
Thank you, Tánaiste. Deputy Lord Barrett.
Every day, households in this country use 300 million litres of water. Do you know how much leaks out of the system every day? 700 million litres of water. Okay? Yeah. This is the Irish Water business plan, okay? This is your crowd, their plan. And what it shows is a drop in investment from 2010 onwards. First, instigated by Fianna Fáil and the Greens, and then by Fine Gael and Labour. The Irish Water business plan repeats on several occasions in its report the decades of underinvestment. Decades of underinvestment. That was done by Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil-led governments. Has things improved slightly since you abandoned the wild goose chase of water charges? Yes, because 250 million a year that was being put into water meters that don't fix leaks has now been redirected into upping the investment programme on water infrastructure.
Time is up, Deputy, please.
But it's still way short. Irish Water testified in this House in April that they need €18 billion investment to fix our water infrastructure. You said it. 38% by 2020. The leakage will only be down to 38%. That's pathetic.
Deputy, you have to.
That doesn't deal with the problem. So we need to significantly increase the investment in water infrastructure, which you have failed to do.
Thank you. Tánaiste to conclude on this matter.
Well, we do need to increase the investment in water infrastructure, and I'm glad that you focused on that, because that is what's needed, and that you haven't focused on the argumentation that you've been giving for years, that actually we should have stuck with the old system of local authorities doing it all on their own, because I hope even you see the logic of moving to a single utility that can actually deal with the economies of scale and the skill sets that come from that, and also plan nationally for how we move water around this island to make sure that we don't have the kind of water shortages that we're threatened by. Can I also say, I think the pressures that we're feeling today reminds us of the logic of the need for excess usage charges. So that if people are blatantly wasting water, is it fair that their neighbours should pay for that? And certainly, is it fair that in a summer like this one,
Will you let the Tánaiste respond, please? Well, Debbie Ellis.
Generally, when I get a response like that, I think it's a recognition that perhaps the Deputy's own approach is fundamentally flawed.
Time is
the Sinn Féin, the Sinn Féin approach to water charges has been inconsistent and a joke, quite frankly, and certainly wouldn't seriously deal with the challenges that the country faces this week and next week and later on in the summer.
Thank you, Tánaiste.
So once again, can I thank Irish Water for the work that they're doing and the coordination that they're providing, and can I reassure then that the government will continue to fund the capital infrastructure that's needed. And to the public, can I say that while everybody, or the vast majority of people at least, are enjoying the good weather at the moment, it does bring pressures that collectively we need to respond to as households and as businesses.
Thank you, Tánaiste. That concludes...